programmer and chief an NHRC funded project at the University of the Arts, London. Her video works have been shown at Victoria and Albert Museum, Nuit Blanche and Toronto Guildhall Art Gallery and elsewhere, numerous film festivals. And what you're going to see now is an interaction with Ripton Lindsay, who I'd like to introduce, and you'll see him again later on this evening. He's been working with the film before today and created a response to what you're going to see, sort of a male perspective on female dance and a sort of call and response. So please welcome Ripton Lindsay to begin the performance of Sitting on a Man.
The dancing was much more varied and attractive than that of the men. The dancers revolved in a large circle, quiet elderly women among them, and some of these remarkable for their grace of movement. Some had anklets that rattled as they were shaken. In many of the dances, the women growled like dogs. At these times, a woman noted for her proficiency in making this noise would go into the middle to lead them.
They didn't have clothes on, but they had like jewellery, like added things around their head, around their waist, around their ankles. Thank you.
performers would sometimes individually, or in twos and threes,
break into apparently impromptu steps on their own with great elan.
There would be a good deal of the distinctively woman's gesture, in which a couple of women
would spring towards each other, one arm upraised, and touch hands at the top of their stretch
in an access of joie de vivre. Again, these flashes of vital energy and excitement struck one in the women's doings.
The very fact that the dance forms such an integral part of the African's existence is perhaps the explanation why I have made so little mention of the air one breathes or the soil one stands on, for it is as much a constant accompaniment of life as sun and rain, wind and heat. It escapes all definitions, defies all analysis. It is in some elusive way Africa.
Although I have been so often in closest contact with the country and the people, although I can remember scenes and looks and words which opened up whole worlds of new understanding, I have only twice been able to say with complete conviction, I am seeing Africa. And on both occasions, I was watching girl children dance.
Thank you.
Upstairs to the first floor, CM 108, which is up the stairs, take a left.